Welcome to Cindy's Table. I'm Cindy. The one thing I love about cooking is sharing it with friends. So today I invited some friends over from CrossFit to enjoy a great post-workout lunch. And after the workout we had this morning, I am sure they're going to love what I have in store for them. So this morning before I left for CrossFit, I thought I would get a jump start on things. And I created a quick and easy guacamole, and all I need to do now is add the final touches to it. I need to add a little bit of cilantro, slice up my cucumbers, and now when the girls arrive, they can enjoy a great snack while I'm creating their meal. So let me start by chopping up the cilantro. And I thought they would like this nice light snack because I am making them a great lunch today. So let me just dice up some cilantro here. And I love the freshness of cilantro in my guacamole. And I like to add it at the end so it stays nice and green and vibrant. Okay, so I added my cilantro. Now all I need to do is mix it all together and my guacamole is done. So it's great that I prepared this morning and now their snack is ready for them when they arrive. The next thing I need to do is slice up the cucumber that they can dip it in. And I think they'll really enjoy the lightness of this snack. So I'm just gonna slice these into thin slices. And they're probably pretty hungry, so I'm gonna give them a nice lunch today. I'm just gonna add these to my plate. Now when the girls arrive, they'll have a great snack waiting for them. Okay, we have the guacamole done, so when the girls arrive, they'll have a nice snack. Now for their lunch, I made them one of my Italian favorites, fagioli. But this morning before I left, I also made my tomato sauce. And it is my grandmother's recipe, and the recipe you can find on my website. I've had it simmering all morning, seasoned with garlic and basil and oregano, and that'll just be sitting on the stove for us to create a delicious fagioli that will go in the sauce, and I'm gonna simmer that for about 3 hours in the oven. But let me get started with the fagioli. To start my fagioli, I'm going to start by sauteing some spinach. And I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil to the bottom of my pan. Next thing I'm going to do is just put my spinach right into my saute pan. And this will only take a minute or so to cook up. But while that is cooking, I'm going to chop up a couple of cloves of garlic. Now for my flank steak, I'm using, it's about 1.5 pounds of flank steak. And I'm gonna just put it into my sauce after I saute it up, and we'll let it cook in the oven on low for about 2 to 3 hours. So let me just get the garlic into my pan. Next thing I'm gonna do is add a little bit of salt and pepper. So I have sea salt here. And then I'm gonna add some freshly ground pepper. Now I like a little heat in my fagioli, so I'm gonna add some red pepper flakes. And I'm probably adding about 1/2 teaspoon to the pan here. There. So we'll just keep an eye on that. But while the spinach is sauteing, I'm gonna prepare my flank steak. So what I have here, it's about 1.5 pounds of grass-fed flank steak. I'm gonna just lay it on my board. Now I want to tenderize it a little bit and thin it out. So by doing that, I'll use a mallet. I'm going to put some clear wrap over the steak. And that'll do a couple of things. It'll protect the meat, but it'll also protect me from getting splattered with the steak. So I'm just going to give it a good pound here. That's good. So see how it's thinner, and it's gonna be a lot easier for me to work with it when I roll it. While I'm waiting for the spinach, I'm gonna season my meat. Just a little bit of salt and pepper. There we go. And some pepper. There. So now my spinach has softened. I don't need to cook it all the way, I just want to soften it. And I'm just going to put it in my bowl. I'm just going to let it cool for a moment. While the spinach is cooling, I want to add some roasted red peppers in here as well. They are full of liquid, so I'm gonna grab a paper towel and put it on my board. And then when I grab, and I just need one pepper, they're pretty large. I just like to drain it with the paper towel. So now what I wanna do is just slice it into thin slices, because we'll be biting into it, so we want nice small pieces. So my roasted peppers are ready, my spinach is ready. Now I just wanna grab my spinach, and it's nice and seasoned with the garlic and roasted red peppers. And oh, I actually wanna add some basil. And about a teaspoon of basil. And then I'm also gonna add some oregano. The same thing, about a teaspoon of oregano. Again, I add oregano and basil to almost all my recipes, the Italian in me. And I really wanna show the girls today my Italian flair of cooking. Okay, now I'm just gonna add an egg, and that'll bind the spinach and the peppers together so everything will stay together in my bourgeois. Okay, so I have that ready. So now what I want to do is take my meat, and I'm gonna add my spinach mixture and the egg. You wanna get some of the egg in there, and the garlic. Wanna make sure you get all the pieces of garlic. That's good. And the next thing I wanna do is add some of my roasted red peppers. And I just wanna lay those along the spinach. And that looks perfect to me. Now what you want to do is roll it. So to roll it, I just keep this meat close to you. It's just tuck in all the vegetables. So now once I have it secure, I'm going to add some kitchen string and tie it all together. And I'm just going to take a pretty long piece. That should be plenty. Now what I do is start on one end and I make a knot right away. Then I just start going around under the meat. Then the last piece what I do is I actually go around the top of the meat, so I can keep all the vegetables inside and then tie it to the first tie that I made in the beginning. So now my vegetables will stay intact. Let me just cut the rest of that string off here. Throw that away. And now I have my meat filled with the spinach, the garlic, I have some nice herbs in there, along with the roasted red peppers. Okay, my bourgeois has been browned on all sides. Now I'm going to add it in the sauce, and then we'll put it in the oven at 275 for about 2 to 3 hours, and then we can have our lunch. So let me do that now. Bourgeois is nice and browned. My sauce is perfectly simmering. Great, I think the girls are here. Hey, thanks for coming. Oh, excited. I have a great lunch planned for you.
Excited.
Oh, Carla. Hey.
For having us.
How do you girls feel from all those kettlebells this morning?
Tired and ready to eat.
Yeah. Well, what I made this morning before I went to the gym is some guacamole, but I just finished it up with some cilantro and some cucumbers. So I thought I'd make you a light snack before we have a great lunch
and
that I
can
have.
Smell it.
You can smell it, it does smell great. So go ahead and dig in. So girls, we worked out so hard this morning, and as part of our lunch, I wanted to give you all a little gift.
Oh, wow.
You're so sweet.
That was so nice.
Thank you.
Yes,
open them up now. It's like my birthday.
I know, well, I thought we'd have a girls' lunch, we'd all have a little gift, and something that I thought you might enjoy.
Oh, that's
oh my God!
Oh my gosh!
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Enjoy your necklaces and enjoy your snack.
You.
And what I'm gonna do now is finish lunch. Lunch is almost ready. While the bourgeois was resting, I decided to roast some asparagus. So I already plated that for you. Now I'm going to come over and plate your brajol. Do you all like brajol? Love it. Good. So I'm just going to slice it up. Oh, and it is cooked perfectly. This looks delicious, smells delicious. Okay. Now I'm just going to plate it. There we go. Okay. I'm just going to add some extra sauce on it. Let me garnish it for them. I'm gonna grab some fresh parsley. There we go. That should be plenty. On there for them. Now here we go. Look at this, girls. We have some brajol and some asparagus. Before you dig in, I'm sure you noticed that you don't have any napkins in front of you. Well, in my Nana's kitchen, we used a mappina. And what we did was we shared it. So if you need to use it, for all friends here, so we're gonna use a mappina today in honor of my grandmother, and this is one of her delicious recipes, so I thought we'd be traditional. So I'll put this right here, and enjoy your lunch.